Hi guys, welcome back to my channel.
See your channel.
Did you get one of those?
Hello. Excuse me.
Yes. Did you get one of those halos that you wanted?
Oh, the ring light. No, I haven't
ring
got one yet.
The ring light.
Yes. We'll try and find one.
Hi.
We're in the channel.
You don't
have to. See ya.
She's gonna come back.
No, I'm going.
Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. My mum's still giggling in the background, I can hear her, so don't be surprised if she comes back in at some point. Because she probably will. So today's video is actually a lower body mobility warm-up. Now it might incorporate some glute activation, I'm not 100% sure yet, but I did post a video of my top 5 glute activation exercises on my Instagram yesterday, so I will link that below if you want to watch that. You really should be performing mobility or activation before all of your sessions, whether this is upper body, whether it's lower body. I was speaking to one of my Perfect Peach girls yesterday who has said to me that she got a little bit lazy with glute activation, because I fully get when you just wanna jump, like get to the gym and jump into a session and just start. But then she'd actually told me that she had seen a major halt in her progress, and from going back to glute activation for about 5 to 10 minutes before her sessions. Now, you don't need to do that much. It's low load drills, you don't need to do them weighted. Add a hip circle resistance band if you wish. I always do. You want to hit the glutes from multiple angles, and the idea is to stimulate them, not completely annihilate them and destroy them before your session. So yeah, I will link that below for you. But today's video is a lower body mobility warm-up that you can do before any of your lower body sessions. Now, I break up my sessions into hamstrings with glute elements on a Monday, solely glutes on Thursday with heavy hip thrusts, and then Saturday I do a leg session that is very quad focused. Now, the routine that I'm going to show you, you can do it before all your workouts, but specifically for the glute one, I would mix things up a little bit. So I'm doing fire hydrants, glute bridges with a band, supermans and more things like that to specifically target my glutes. If you do like this video and find it helpful, or if you want to ask me any comments, please give it a thumbs up and just comment anything you wish below, and I will get back to you.
I'm off to the gym now, and I'm going to have a little snack. I think Mum's made me a salad for later.
Your half is in the fridge.
I'm just gonna have a snack, and then I've got a salad later.
Oh, look at it.
Ooh, we'll have a look at the salad. But because I'm training, and then I have video. She's labelled them. Thanks, Mum. But yes, because I have physio and I'm training, I won't get around eating until around 3 o'clock now, so obviously I need a snack. And I'm actually just gonna have some soda bread because it's my favorite, and I'm gonna put a little bit of butter on it.
So I've actually just finished my session. I did shoulders and then a WOD, and I'm gonna also link the WOD like I did the glute activation because it is super hard. And now I'm gonna show you the mobility exercises. We've got glutes, quads and
the key muscle group to activate prior to training your legs is the hamstrings, and actually I don't think most people do it. So the hamstrings are phasic muscles. Now, a phasic muscle contains mostly fast twitch muscle fibers and are therefore more suited to movement. They're also more easily fatigable. Activating explosive phasic muscles will increase metabolism because they burn more calories than postural muscles. The hamstrings and glutes are phasic muscles mostly, and the erector spinae, lower back muscles, are postural. This is why people claim deadlifts and squats are bad for their back. They can't activate their glutes and hamstrings after years of sitting in a chair, so when the small back muscles contract over a bent over spine, they get quite sore. Activating the hamstrings in a phasic, explosive on and off way, like using the Swiss ball, are perfect to get the most out of your hamstrings and prevent pains elsewhere.
The hamstrings have two roles: bend the knee, which is flexion, and straighten at the hip, which is extension. These exercises work on the hip component and help to work at end range. This is a great way to get them working efficiently, especially before deadlifting or squatting. The emphasis here on both the banded good mornings and the single leg Romanians is that I'm pivoting at the hip, and so there is no lower back arching. This encourages the hamstrings and not the lower back to drive the movement.
The goblet squat is a movement that can help anyone master squatting form. The setup of the goblet squat, from the foot position to the way the weight is cradled against the chest, essentially sets you up for solid form from the start. It's even great for those with poor ankle mobility, poor wrist flexibility, tight lats and or injured shoulders. Hold the weight against the chest. If you have a kettlebell, grab it by the horns, but with a dumbbell, hold one of the heads up vertically between your palms. Position your feet so your stance is slightly wider than shoulder width, with your toes pointed slightly out. Keep your chest upright and squat. Lateral band walks have become a staple exercise in many people's warm-up routines, and for good reason, as it's been shown in numerous studies that these exercises have high levels of gluteal activity. It's important that you don't lose attention out of the band at any point. By keeping a constant tension in the band, you encourage better glute recruitment and get the most out of it. It's also so important that you keep your hips level throughout. Use a mirror and place your hands on your pelvis as you do it, as you can see that I'm doing in the video. It's really easy to cheat and activate the lower back muscles and not the glutes. Loads of people do a clam to help them activate the glutes prior to training, more specifically the glute medius, which is great as it's used as a dynamic stabiliser of the hip during single leg standing moves, including walking and jogging. Make sure you get the most out of these by ensuring you set the pelvis to the right position by activating the obliques too. As you can see from the video, I create a lift just above my pelvis. This starts the move off in the right pelvic alignment and encourages good glute recruitment. Here we make the exercise more challenging by lifting the feet. This allows the hip to work through a greater range of movement and also places a stability challenge on the leg. This is a great way to activate muscles, but also prevent any unwanted injuries too. The final exercise is a reverse lunge and twist. This lunge variation works the entire body, and adding the twist ensures that your obliques get a little extra attention. Keep your core stable and take a large step back with one leg, planting your foot and then lowering your body until both legs are bent in right angles. As you sink into the lunge, twist your torso. In order to keep the glutes working at their best, ensure that your knee doesn't move inwards at the forward leg. And as you twist, maintain your posture and get those obliques working the twist. Use a mirror if you are struggling.
So I've just had actual physio, is that what you call it? Actual physio?
Actual physio.
Just had actual physio on my lower back as always, and a little bit on my lats and upper back today because more so than usual. I hope you enjoyed the mobility stuff because it's going to be highly beneficial to you. What we would say is to do around 30 seconds on each of the exercises. Each exercise should take about 2 minutes, but obviously it's dependent on you as a person. You might need to do more, you might do a little bit less. You've got your glutes, your quads, and your hamstrings. But now I'm really going to quickly show you what K-tape is, because it's always the blue strips that are on my back in my videos, and people think it's like a tattoo, like they don't know what it is. So I just thought I'd show you what it is. What actually is it?
It's tape that you can stick on your back that has a fingerprint pattern to the glue, which mimics the skin, so we can put it on. It has a bit of a stretch to it, gives you a bit of feedback so you know where your back is and you don't go into the wrong posture. It also will allow for a bit of lifting of the layers of the skin and the muscle, just to give you a bit of drainage, and if you do have any sort of inflammation there from overuse, then it will help you heal.
Yeah, love that.
And just slight bend forwards, a little bit more. Perfect. Okay.
See, this is the tape. But it's black today, not blue. I really hoped you enjoyed this video and that it was helpful for you. I know it's a little bit different than my usual workout videos, but hopefully you found it beneficial. And I'll see you in my next one. Bye!